Hey everyone! This time I made a diorama with the Lizardfolk and the Necromancer. I started everything in Blender. I sculpted one of the lizardmen, then made two variations of it with different accessories, head and back spikes or crest thingies. 3D sculpting or 3D softwares in general can be intimidating for the first sight, but if you want to enjoy the freedom of creating any mini you want, it's worth a shot. If I could learn Blender on this hobby level, chances are high that you can too. With the spread of cheap resin printers, you can make anything if you can use a 3D program. Blender is free, and for a few years now, it became very user-friendly. I will link it in the description. For the older Shaman Lizardman stuff, I made some human skulls. I modified one of them to be the face of the Necromancer too. I didn't do any research on how D&D Necromancers look like, I just made this floating specter-like skull face with the twisted robe. It was a bit featureless, so I made the pointy shoulders and later the ring that I painted like a golden halo. When I first started to plan this diorama, I pictured it with a tree. So I watched a few tutorials and I thought this will be easy peasy. I couldn't be more wrong. I hate this tree and this whole technique, so I wrote a little note to future me. I thought I know better than Luke Towen, so I tried to make the bark from dust air drying clay. Of course, I'm an idiot, and this would have been a ridiculous amount of time. Then I changed to liquid latex, but with a little twist. I put layers of toilet paper on it to form the bark texture. As you see, this also isn't a time saver. This was the point when I started to trust the smarter, and applied just the liquid latex. Here I am drafting the layout to the wrong side of the base. I roughly cut out the heel from XPS foam and glued it to the fiberboard. While it dried, I painted the tree with multiple layers of grey and burnt umber. Unfortunately, the latex didn't hold paint very well, so it kept coming off from the trunk where I touched it. I dry brushed the tree with beige, but since later I had to fix the painting, it was useless. Yes, gluing the clump foliage to the branches was a lot of fun. I tried to cover them with PVA glue and pushed the little fuckers into it. Of course, that didn't work. So I pushed the whole tree into the foliage. The result was acceptable, but not satisfactory. I used spray adhesive to stick more of that shit onto the tree. When it dried, I sprayed it again, but this time I sprinkled on smaller different size flocking to make the surface of the grindy sponge visually more interesting. Then I sprayed the tree with diluted PVA to hold it together. I just got an airbrush, so finally I could make a zenithal priming. I can't, and therefore I don't like to paint minis. So this part will be short. I used ink for the Necromancer, but besides the base coats, I painted the Lizardfolk with oils. It's nice to have fixing options when somebody is so bad in painting as me. And blending oils is fun. I just had to add secretive to make it dry faster. This is a very cheap paint, so maybe because of that, without help it never dries. I mixed up my DIY modeling compound based on Luke Fellow's recipe and built up the terrain using the majestic pine bark. If you want to start making terrain with zero money, the only thing you need is pine bark. Using the modeling compound, I created the riverbed and placed some smaller broken plaster pieces here and there as rocks. I also mixed sand and plaster together to cover the riverbed with it. I hope you see the process better through my glasses. I made a zenithal undercoat on the terrain too. Then airbrushed yellow ochre and sepia all over the stone surfaces. After that I brushed some burnt umber wash on a few places. I dry brushed the stones with tan and beige. If you like this video, please consider subscribing and click the bell button. Also hit like and comment some nice words, it would greatly help the channel. Thank you. The riverbed and the grassy places were painted to dark brown. I applied PVA glue to the latter to prepare for the static grass. I made an applicator from an electric fly sweater and a kitchen strainer. The grass is hemp rope cut and painted. I made a new batch of modeling compound, now with desaturated brown paint, to attach the tree. It went great. Dry brushed the base of the tree with beige and brown, and off camera applied the grass. I fixed the tree's fallen foliage with CA glue. Next, I tried to make the water effect with clear drying acrylic sealant. And the keywords here are clear drying. Since it's white, you can just guess in what miraculous color it will shine after it's set. It looked so bright, so I was kept adding blue and black and a little yellow. I tried to distribute it evenly in the riverbed. And I think I had semi-decent results. It's not bad from a distance. I painted those mysterious plants and this branch with a darker and a brighter ochre, then applied diluted burnt umber paint. I sprayed glue on these plants and dipped them into the flocking. Later I found that they look much better without that, so I removed the flocking from most of them and glued them to the chosen places. I also glued these small roots under some rocks for a little more visual interest. Fixed everything with watered down PVA and applied a tasteful amount of pigment powder. I wanted this place to look like an idyllic camping site where terrible things are about to happen. The, let's just call it, Black River needed some more waves, so Heavy Body Gale was my friend. I couldn't help myself and made a little moss here and there. After it dried a bit, I scraped off the excess. This I did not like. This I maybe will like more. I repeated the painting but left it without moss. For the sake of repairability, I painted the waves with white oil paint, and I can tell you, I got good use of it. And now, nothing more left but to roll the beauty shots. So here is the encounter at Black River Diorama. A lot of struggle to make this diorama with the tree and some parts of the terrain, and to be honest, there was a point when it seemed like it won't come together. But it was worse to force myself through those difficulties. I like the outcome, but I refuse to say out loud the moral of the story,